Hey guys, what's up? It's Matt. Today we're going to use the CDN of FlyingPress to see if that really speeds up our website from different parts of the world. We're gonna dive in right now. In the last tutorial, we talked about FlyingPress, how to install it, how to set it up to get good caching results. Today we're gonna add a CDN to this FlyingPress installation to see if that actually speeds up more of our website. So when do you actually need a CDN? Your website is hosted on a server somewhere in the world. That's no problem if your target audience is also from the same region. But as business expands or your international blog is getting more and more traction, then it might be possible that people from other countries are also visiting your website. Now that might cause a problem as loading times increase if they go overseas, etc. And that's where a CDN kicks in. A content delivery network is a network of servers which are actually copying some elements of your website so that it's being served from other servers all around the world closest to your visitor. Now that's very useful and might speed up things on your website. So what we're going to do from the dashboard, we go to CDN over there. You can see FlyingCDN, lightning fast content delivery, no matter in the world your visitors are located. Now what do we have? Image compression and WebP conversion, adaptive image delivery, nice, permanent storage, 114 edge location for worldwide coverage. That sounds good. 26 milliseconds worldwide latency, that's very low. SEO headers and SSL DDoS protection. All right, well, we're gonna try this. So we're gonna press on get FlyingCDN over here. And then we are here at flyingcdn.com. Now, this is the way it works. I already told you that. They also have an interesting comparison table with Cloudflare, Cloudflare Pro, Rocket CDN, and FlyingCDN. Now, the difference is, of course, that FlyingCDN is not very expensive. They also have 114 edge locations, which is more than Rocket CDN, but less than Cloudflare Pro. But hey, that's why you pay for it. And you have always access to all locations, global file replication, permanent storage. Right, all of these things sounds really good. Now let's just test it out. I'm gonna sign into my account over here. And then they've sent me a mail. And now we are inside of FlyingCDN. The only things we can do over here is create a new CDN. We're doing that in just a second. You can recharge your account and manage your billing and card. At the payment methods, you can add a payment method, and then you have your billing information, and then you have your invoice history when you have paid. And if you click over here, you can go to the add payment method, and here you can add in your credit card so that you can recharge your account. And when you click on recharge account, you will see this screen, and here we can recharge our account with, for example, $40. So we can use that CDN for 1 month. Just add in your credit card information and press pay. Now we have some account balance, so let's create a new CDN. Enter in our website URL and press create. All right, that's it. Now we have created our URL over here, and then we have our own URL, and we need to copy this in URL. So click on this button, and then we have copied it. A meter which tells us how much bandwidth we've been using in the last past months, because you have a limit of 100 gigabyte per month. I don't think that's gonna be a problem as we don't have a million visitors each month, so that should be fine. Let's get back to WordPress. And in these FlyingPress CDN settings, we're gonna enable the CDN and we're gonna paste here the URL that we've just created. Then you can choose the file types. Do you want to deliver all files from CDN or just CSS, JavaScript and fonts or images? Of course, we wanna do all files. Press save changes. Now here we go, the CDN is working right now. Let's purge the caches, purge everything and preload just to be sure. Then we go back to our page speed insight results from the last time, but also the GT metrics report from last time and the pingdom speed test from last time. They're all great, but now we're gonna try to test from a different kind of part of the world. We're gonna test them all again. How are we gonna do that? Just copy this entire URL, go to new tab, paste it in over here. And then we're gonna press analyze again. The same with GT metrics, copy it, paste it in over there and press retest. Then with pingdom also, copy it, new tab. And we're gonna retest it, but this time we're gonna use North America, Washington DC, start test. With PageSpeed Insight, we now have a 93 performance. So that's actually pretty good. If we compare it with the other test, Then we have a 3-point through and a page size of 2 MBs. And now we have a load time of 1 second and a page size has been reduced almost by half. So this CDN actually really does something. And even with GT metrics, you can see that from London, UK, this is the performance. And from San Antonio, Texas, USA, it's even a little bit faster if you're calculating total blocking time. But hey, my server is not in the USA, so I'm pretty content with this CDN. And also my ping and website speed tests are not very bad. The load time actually went up from 3 seconds with an A to 1 second. I think this FlyingPress CDN test is very interesting. So if you're looking for a CDN, FlyingPress actually could do the job for you. If you have any questions or you just want to say thank you, Matt, drop them down in the comments. I'll always reply. Hit that like button if I helped you out so I know I was on the right track. And of course, subscribe over there if you want to see more WordPress related videos. And also check out this video, which is also amazing and not delivered by any content delivery network. I think, but I guess that YouTube is also using CDNs.